sometimes it depresses me to think that I think about a problem in computer operating systems, and then I go and visit colleagues at Microsoft who've got 1,000 people thinking about that problem, and I wonder what progress I can make. And yet, they find value in talking to us because we can do some good work on theory, and we can also innovate in ways that they can't because they're constrained by a corporate context.
We're doing what you would expect in terms of the computer science piece on cyber detection, but we're working with psychologists to better understand how we might input human behavioural aspects into that system. But we're also working very closely with the business school so we can understand, whilst we're designing the technologies that might sense these attacks, at the same time we can consider the potential for operational disruption in an enterprise and build the awareness campaigns that we would need to deliver to the executive boards and the staff of that enterprise to help them to adopt our ideas. We know for sure that every citizen of cyberspace, which is basically all of us to varying degrees, and in the near future will be all of us, has a role to play. Any point of access into cyberspace is potentially a point of attack, but we have a challenge because of the complexity of the message, and not just the complexity of the message, but the complexity of what we're going to ask people to do. It's not going to be as simple as put your seatbelt on when you're in the car. Can we visualize what's happening in cyberspace in a way that's much more intuitive to a human, that would enable a human to spot something that doesn't quite fit, that looks wrong, and then raise an alert? So one of the things we've been working on in the visual analytics space is enabling the technical staff who get given these alerts to connect this with the priorities of an enterprise, the tasks that are being undertaken today, so that I can get this aircraft in the air, are we doing a mergers and acquisition? And we can connect and predict the impact or the consequences of these potential attacks, because these alerts are not always correct. You have to determine which 10 of these 300, 3,000, 3 million you should really take action on. This is how we predict the consequence would be for you. And the idea is that the analyst can very quickly say, of all of these millions of alerts, I just need to go fix this one box over here first, and everything keeps going in the organisation.
So there's very much a two-way flow of both information and expertise and ideas about things that are worth trying, and I wouldn't have it any other way.